Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Get Nana Habo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.
People, fresh new week, and the year is coming to an end. Like, seriously, Munange, it's about the time of the year where you keep asking yourself, so what else? What next? What else? What next? But hey, in the world of gossip, I think nothing ever changes. It's still too much juicy gossip, shade throwing. Every game that I call. My name is Tina Fierce One, and this is an episode that is proudly sponsored by Nana Habo Mouthwash. Get the product, try the product. It's a new week. Let's get it. I get to my Instagram and anonymous tip hollers, they slide into my DM and they're like, Banange Tina, tuyambo tugambile koko basaji abatagala kusasula child support. Mbutuli bako tugenda batu sake ni saka. I'm like, wait, girlfriend, calm down. Women have been fighting that battle for quite some time. Yes, they have. I don't know how successful you'll be, but girl, have at it. We've all tried it at some point. So she comes out and she says, Tina, Twine Chizibo. So you know Jeff Chiwa? I'm like, duh, who doesn't know Jeff Chiwa? And then it goes like, so Jeff Chiwa has a brother. The brother is called Alan Chiwa. I'm like, mm-hmm, I'm following. I've heard of him too. And she goes like, Yazala mumukazi wanolubutwe omwana. Tabarabidida. Taba wabu yambi, newe baba kubira masimu tebaina chebakola, newe baba kubira Jeff taina baba yamba, omwana alieno tasoma, apparently neza fizite zidi, whoa, omwana tasoma asiba kukalo, abona abona. That's what she said. I was like, what? I was appalled, I was pissed. I was about to jump to conclusion until, before I could, you know, before the story comes to run, I have to validate it. I asked a couple of people, they're like, because rumor and right rumor has it. Do you even know their lineage? Like, mutabazala. I was like, wait, how do you even know that? Like, how? Nangamba Tina, trust me, Kugambi. Bali, tebazala. In short, they are impotent. I was like, oh, okay. I was like, okay. And I have to get a question, but seriously though, at the end of the day, this is the part where I want to reach out to all you annoying, useless baby fathers. This, you are trying these women's patience too bad these days. You are trying, and we are at an edge and an era where women are like, I can do this too. So, mubagende pola. I saw this a couple of weeks back, and I at first it was just a story that like, oh, Zari's in the country, she's gonna do something, and the next thing we knew she was taking photos with the Minister of Tourism. Next thing we know, they're like, oh well, she's going to be a tourism ambassador. I was like, the irony, indeed. That is the kind of things I was saying. Like, you see how they got that wildlife poaching thing and they put different celebrity faces and we're all like, what are these guys going to do for us? They don't even know anything about wildlife or poaching. Now, I feel the Minister for Tourism was straight on the money. Oh yeah, she's the better, she's one of the few exports we have. Like, she represents for Uganda in, she does it alone. Like, yeah, but I still believe there's a bunch of women out there seated like, wait, so if she's a tourism ambassador, does it mean whoever bangs her feels they have banged a piece of Uganda? I was like, no, not me. That girl is dry and stuff. No, she's representing for something else. But hey, Kongs, it's in order. She's trying to secure that bag. Secure. Oh well, another Mayanja story. We can't help it. They're part of us. They're with us, for us, by us. I will created the monsters that we are fighting right now. We gave them too much. No, they deserved it. Chameleon deserved it. Chameleon done good things. Anywho, there's this guy, boy, man, what should I call him? Come eat him, Sajava, nice. I'm disrespecting. Anyway, this guy calls himself Black Skin. Now, he reached out to us and he had issues. He goes like, I needed to put my story out there. We're like, okay, Dish, what's happening? You know, Lugamboru Woma. And goes like, so you know that new Chameleon song, Tatizo? We're like, yeah, we know the song. It's like, I produced that song. And the thing that is bothering me right now is that I produced the song. Chameleon didn't even pay me for producing that song, not even a shilling. But what hurt him the most is that with all that going on, when he was giving credit to the people who are behind it, he never gave me credit. So he was, you know, up in arms, and he was like, yo, what, chameleon, this, man. But my question, though, I just kept wanting to ask him, oyagala sentence oba kusasule, oba, just like, let us know. And this is what he had to say.
No, tatizo luluimba luange, chameleon yagendo kujo kusangano luluimba. I had that song 6 months ago. Nekati weyaja mstudio ya fe. Like, he told the producer to call me. Nemu playing out some of the demos. Na ina demos bili. Yalo ndako tatizo. Chitegira nemu gamba, it's okay, you're gonna work. Chitegira, and it's my song. Those are my rights. Moral rights and economic rights. Uruimba tuwa tegira gana alukole. Whereby he had to pay me. Chitegira, te yansa sura. Which is, chitegira, uruimba na luandika. I wrote that song. If you are taking my song, you have to pay me. Me, I accepted him to record the song. You get, do everything, but he had to pay me. He never paid me. And then, what pissed me off, when we went to Facebook, I was crediting the producer, even the victims, not crediting the writer of the song, Black Skin. Chitegera, katete yampa na kasente, chechasizo kumu virana katichano mienyo. Chitegera, I'm wondering what kind of person is that? Kati ampe sente zange, chitegero imba wangendu wakala milioni tano, azimpe, zuka, zagala sente nyingi, milioni tano.
Still moving on, so Viboyo Oweyo was arrested during the weekend. Reason that he wrote abusive words and language and lyrical content that was not befitting when he called out different political figures, so he was arrested. One more can go with this story. It's Viboyo. That's the most news he has made in 7 years. Proud of you, bruv. You're finally back on the radar. And yes, to almost say bye-bye. So Rita Kagwa, blogger, we all know her. She goes to her page and she posted this story that was sent to her apparently by someone, an anonymous tip. The story goes that Eddie Kenzo is living where? Texas or Boston? He's living in one of those two places. I haven't yet gotten it. And the whole story here is that he's living with this chick called Salma, and she's actually expecting his baby. Like, they are a situationship turned into a relationship. There is mad love. And, well, Kenzo is pretty much left Rema for her. Now, Kenzo gets the same story, puts it up on his page because he knows he has way too many wololos and they have time to, you know, attack anyone and everyone. Rita tried her best, you know, she kept going back and forth for one of them. But here's the thing, though, I've had this, there's no smoke without fire. I've had the Eddie Kenzo rumor between him and Rema for way too long. And every passing day, we try to delve deeper and dig dirty to find out what exactly is these people's problem. Now, from what I've gathered, yes, the love ain't there no more. Eddie Kenzo is out there banging and bowling and doing what the heck he's gonna do. And I feel the reason why he's doing that is because what you get, I remember where I saw Kane Yegana Kenzo nga Kenzo Mavu. You know what a man can do? You'll be like, oh, onganyo loko andi mavu kanzi. Kole, mkulumi. Like, you could just be a point of reference in his life. Anyway, the love ain't there, really. And they've not been staying together for a while. So I asked myself, I'm like, but why would Rema, a beautiful, talented young woman with only one child, hello, honey. I have three, and at any one moment, I'm ready to pick up sticks and move into the next direction. But she has one. One. Why would she sit back and go through all this humiliation? And it's not just the stories about who he's sleeping with or what he's gonna do with his life. It's more like, the thing that bothers me is like when he comes for radio interviews or TV interviews and anything about Rema is asked, like, his answers are always vague and slightly shade Rema, you know. Then they told me, well, here's the situation. Yes, the love died, it did. They keep it together for the public reason. Now this is the part Jenja Galo Soko Kumanya Mbwe Nyumba Kenzo Jeyafuna after the BET. Yes, that house that he posted and plastered everywhere. Yes, it's his house. But Rema, yate kamu sentezi. Now, because they could not get along, Kenzo pretty much never stays home at all. He never bothers. He's like catching flights, no feelings. He's like, I'm done with it. Rema stays home in the house. Now, one of them is waiting for the other. Chimutami, chimutuke wan, achikowe. I'll be parking it again. Then Rema won't move an inch because she says, yo, I put money on this house too. So I'm not moving an inch. Eddie Kenzo is like, bona kwa wanga mnazebi ngendo kukolo, jaku weto ogendi. I'm like, why? Why, people? You have but one life. If you are miserable with somebody, I keep saying this, no one is worth taking that life, that happiness, that freedom, that peace, that inner peace away from you. These are all rumors. Mbu ndino. I'm just waiting because like every passing week when we delve deeper, the story gets juicier and juicier and juicier. Like it's so much fun. I can't wait to give you the bigger picture. Wait, other than that, at TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop and at TinaFierce1. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's at TinaFierce1 with an H. I'm out. Episode was proudly sponsored by Nana Herbal Mouthwash. And yes, my sister company on the 20th definitely has something going down for all you party animals. XFM is organizing this beautiful shindig. Ooh, we have a bash, baby. We're going to be drinking on the streets, having a jolly old good time. Make the time, you know, get yourself a ticket. Like, for real, get yourself a ticket. I'm out. Peace.
Scoop was sponsored by
Get Nana Herbal Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.